Hi guys, welcome to WebSensePro. I'm your host Bilal Nasir again with a new feature release video. And in this video, my co-host Nida Sheikh will walk you through how you can set up templates in one single loop builder. So you can set multiple templates within a loop builder where you are pulling up all of the posts from the backend, but you can display multiple templates, alternative templates within one loop builder. It's a cool feature, right? So if you want to learn, stick to the video. Don't forget to subscribe to the channel, comment on the video below. Without further ado, let's jump into the screen.
Guys, welcome back to WebSensePro. I'm your co-host Nida Sheikh with another tutorial on Elementor. As you guys know that Elementor has launched new 3.14 beta edition of Elementor and Elementor Pro. So previously in my tutorial, I've shown you guys how you can use the nesting element. Today in this tutorial, I'll show you how you can use the loop grid static item position function. So stay with me. I'll show you how you can use it. So our first step is to add a new page. I'll name it as static item position. That is loop grid. Okay, so I'll click edit with Elementor here. Okay, so this is the page I'll be working on. My first step is to find loop grid and drag it on the screen like this. The loop grid is added now. Okay, you get three grids as you guys can see. What we need to do is we need to create a template. Either you can add the template from here, if you already have, you can choose a template or you can create one. So I'll be creating the template here. Okay, so what I'll do is I'll add a, these are probably the widget which we use while making loops. So first of all, I'll be adding the post title here. Okay, so this is the title which I've already selected for the post. So it has automatically added it. Now, second step is to add the featured image. Okay, so I'll add post excerpt here. And a button. Below this. Now button is added. Now we'll sort it out. I've done the editing part. What I need to do more is I need to click this and go to content here to link it to post URL. Now I'll show you how all the posts comes in a loop with the same template. When I click save and changes here, this is what happened. When we choose loop grid here, what options we get is apply and alternate template. You need to click this and here you can start typing the name of the templates which you already have. Now, how you can get templates, I'll show you. Okay, so I'm opening a new tab here. From templates, either you can choose one template or you can make templates whichever you want to place it in the loop. Okay, so I'll type the name of the template which I've already made. Okay, so let's see if it works. You guys can see that it's not working yet. One more thing which we need to do is we need to on the static item position here and we need to choose the position where we want the template to be placed in our grid. So I'll choose 2. Now let's see what happens. This is what happens. Let me preview it for you guys. Okay, so let's see how it looks. Okay, so this is how it looks. Okay, we can add in the third template and so on, however we want. Okay, I'll show you one more time how you can add the template. Click add items here. You get one more option for alternate template. You need to click this and here you can choose the template. For example, I have a template named as travel diary. So let's see if we can find it. Okay, it's there. Okay, you can see it is not placed yet. What we need to do is we need to on the static item position here and we need to choose the position of the template in the grid where we want to place the template. Okay, so on the third number, let's see how it looks. So this is the final look of the template I made, added, and how it looks. Let's see. Let's click preview changes and see how it looks. So this is how it looks. If I click next, you'll get the other loop if we have any slide. So let's see. We have one more slide. Okay, so this is the previous one. You guys can see that you can add your own template in between this, and if you want, you can use it on the same template. So this is a very good option given in this 3.14 beta named as loop create static item position. Okay, so I'll show you guys how I added this pagination and this effect. Okay, when you go to loop grid here, there's below, scroll down and see this pagination option. You can choose the page limit, the previous, next, previous, and you can do all the settings you want. Okay, if I click preview, okay, so you guys can see the look which we are getting. It's really nice. So I hope you like my tutorial. If you want more such videos, please don't forget to subscribe my channel, hit the like button and comment below.